Hello everyone, in this video, I'll be walking you through 5 things you can do in your first session within Zoho Desk. So, if you're someone who has signed up for a free trial and confused about where to begin, then this video is for you. Whether you're moving from conventional mailbox to a help desk software, or migrating from one help desk software to another, you might want to start your evaluation process with some basics like organizing your help desk with departments, adding your support agents, setting up the email channel, enabling customer happiness ratings, and creating and responding to tickets. So without further ado, let's get started. Alright, first thing in the list is organizing your help desk with departments. But why should you do it? Let's take an example of a consumer electronics firm called Zilker. Zilker has several internal units that carry out various operations. You could perhaps classify their departments based on business functions like billing, returns, and technical support, based on products and services like smartphones, tablets, in this case, Z Phone and Z Pad, and based on customer segment like the ones who have opted for premium support and the ones who haven't. Most companies usually have multiple departments like these, and each of them functions differently. They will have dedicated support reps and different KPIs. For example, the SLA for general support tickets will be different from that of paid support requests, right? So therefore, it is important to compartmentalize requests from different departments in your help desk software. By adding departments, you can have separate mailboxes, social media channels, community forums, and even automation rules for every function. Now let's see how you can set up departments in Zoho Desk. Click on the settings icon in the top bar. Here, select departments under general settings. What you see in this screen is a default department. That is, when you create a Zoho Desk account, by entering your organization's details, the system creates a department for you. I'd like to keep this one for general inquiries. Now, let's see how to create a new department for returns and refunds. Click on the New Department option right here. Enter the name of the department for internal use. You can either choose to display the same on your help center or give it a different name. You can also add a logo for every department you create using this upload option. Now, from the drop-down, you can select the agents you'd like to associate with this department. But since I haven't added my team, I'm going to skip this one for now. You may also add a description if you'd like. Lastly, you can configure the channels for this department. But since this isn't a mandatory step and we're going to be covering this later in this video, I'm going to skip this one too. That's it. You've created a department. Now that you have your departments ready, next step is to invite your team to your desk portal. To add agents, click on the setup icon in the top right corner. Now, select Agents under Users and Control. Click on the New Agent option and fill in the details, first name, last name, and email. Then choose the roles and permissions you'd like to assign for this user. Zoho Desk gives you 4 options for this. The first one is Agents. Now, agents are support reps who can view, edit, and respond to tickets. You can either give them access to all tickets or only to those that are assigned to them. Second one is admins. As the name explains, they have administrative access to your portal. They can access all modules, set up automations, and basically they can perform any action in your portal. The third one is light agent. Now these people are users who have read-only permissions. Last one is the custom option. If you want to customize a user's access and permissions further, you can choose specific roles and profiles that define their eligibility to perform any action in your help desk. To put it in simpler words, roles is like an org chart. You will have a CEO, support manager, product manager, sales reps, and marketers. Each of them will want to monitor support tickets for a different purpose. Some may just want to keep an eye on the overall picture, while some may want to respond to tickets or interact with customers directly. You can control all of that here by adding custom rules. Profiles define user permissions at a much granular level. You can define whether a user can view, add, modify, or delete a record in a module. For example, a newbie agent will not require access to multiple departments. So likewise, you can create custom profiles to suit your needs better. Now that we know what roles and profiles mean, I'm going to choose agents and give this user, James, access to all tickets. Next step is to choose the departments you want to associate your agents with. I'm going to go ahead and add him to the department I just created, Returns and Refunds. Hit the New Agent option and save. Once you do this, your agents will receive an email invitation to join your portal. Accept the invitation, create a Zoho account, and that's it. Once you've added departments and agents, you need to set up a channel through which your help desk can receive tickets. I'm going to set up the email channel here. So this process can be split into two parts. The first step is to export customer emails to Zoho Desk, and the second step is to authenticate your response email address. But before you set up the email channel, you need to know what your default support email is. So go to the setup icon and select email. Now select new support email. What you see here is your default support email. This is what brings in customer emails from your official support mailbox to Zoho Desk. My support mailbox is a Gmail account, so to export emails from this account to Zoho Desk, I need to forward them to my default Zoho Desk email. In addition to the default email, you can also create email aliases specific for every department in your Zoho Desk portal. So to do that, click New Support Email Address and choose any department from the drop-down. I'm going to choose the one that I just created, Returns and Refunds, and create an email alias for that department and save it. Now that you know the default desk email for returns and refunds, the next step is to forward the refund-related emails from your official mailbox to your desk portal. To do that, go to Settings in your support mailbox. I'm opening my Gmail settings. And here, select Forwarding. Now, create a filter to forward only refund-related emails. Enter the ID you want to forward these emails to. I'm pasting the default desk ID I created for Returns and Refunds Department. You will receive a verification email as a ticket in the Returns and Refunds Department of your portal. Copy that verification code and authenticate it in your mailbox. Enable email forwarding option and save your changes. That's it, you've set up email forwarding. Now it's time to add a new response email address. But why should you do this? Because if you don't add one, all ticket replies will be sent from your default desk email and not from your official email ID, which your customers know. So to set up a response email address, go to email settings and select from address. Choose new from address and enter your company's official support email ID here. I'm entering my Gmail ID. Once you hit save, you will receive an authentication email to your company's official support email address. Complete the authentication process and you'll be able to reply to tickets from Zoho Desk using the new from address. So now that you've set up the basic capabilities, let's take a look at the sample ticket Zoho Desk has created for you. Zoho Desk organizes ticket and customer information in the best possible way. So, if at any point you want to reopen a ticket, you have all the important information in a single UI. You can see ticket information like the channel, description, ticket ID, date and time it was created, and department. Your agents can track the time they spend on a ticket by running the on-screen timer manually. You can forward or reply to the ticket from the response editor. When your team resolves a new issue for which you don't have a knowledge base article, you can create a resolution note and add it to your knowledge base from the response editor itself. So the next time any agent comes across a similar ticket, your resolution note will appear as a suggested article which they can use in their responses. You can also see the billable hours for a ticket, attachments, related activities like calls and tasks. You can also create approval request and view ticket history. On the left side, there are some tools that can enhance your productivity. The first widget displays ticket properties like customer details, date and time the ticket was created, status, and the priority of the ticket. The second widget displays help articles from your knowledge base which are relevant to the ticket. You can simply click on the most relevant one and paste it on the response editor. This saves a lot of time for your agents and allows them to focus on other important tasks. The third one is the timeline widget. Here, you can see all the previous conversations your team has had with your customer. This will help you understand your customer's journey and gauge the actual priority of the ticket. Alright, now you're just one step away from conducting your pilot test. Getting your customer's feedback about your service is the only way to understand whether you're meeting their expectations or not. To know your CSAT score, go to Settings again. Select Customer Happiness Ratings under General Settings. Customize the question and ratings as you wish. Choose whether you want the rating link to be added in every response sent or only when a ticket is closed. You may also choose for which ratings you'd like to reopen the tickets. And lastly, choose the departments for which you'd like to enable this survey. I'm choosing all departments. Save and close. Now you have everything you need to begin your pilot operation. It's time to create a new ticket. I'm going to send an email from a mock customer account to my official email ID. I've sent an email now. Let's see if we have received it as a ticket in Zoho Desk. Yes, there it is. Now open, type out a response, and close the ticket. Moving back to the customer's account to verify, yes, we've received the response too, along with a link to the CSAT survey. Now, test if the survey is working fine by clicking on a rating. That's it. You've created, responded to, and closed your first ticket. You can view the CSAT report in the headquarters to monitor your agent's performance and work on ways to improve your customer satisfaction. Wasn't that quick and simple? Do try to set up these capabilities and let us know about your experience in the comments below. If you have any other questions, feel free to tweet or write an email to our support team. Thanks for watching this video and stay tuned for more such content.